in a net and was tended to by emergency personnel and has been taken from the ice on a stretcher. Ondrej Pavelec at the top left. Eyes shut there and was relatively motionless for nearly 10 minutes. On strides Chris Mason to take his place.
And I think the one referee down in the corner to the right of Nuvi, Neuvert for the Caps, is just waiting for somebody to talk to him to see the condition that Pavlik is in, Joe. He's waiting at the door, waiting for somebody to come out that can tell him what's happening here before they restart play here in Atlanta. He's just waiting. They haven't blown the whistle to start this game back up, so we could still have a little bit of a delay here, Joe. That's what I think's happening right now.
Yeah, and we hate to leave our viewers in the dark, but we're there with you on this one. There is no idea as to what is going on that has been relayed to us. 2 minutes and 25 seconds in, and from what we understand, with Pavlik taken to a nearby hospital, the game cannot continue until another emergency vehicle is on the premises in case it were needed for another injury or illness, etc. So that could be the wait that we are enduring now.
Well, they're making sure they have everything in order. Exactly right, that the referees would wait for this to make sure everything's set before the play resumes here in Atlanta.
17:35 to go, still in this first period. Scoreless in Atlanta on CSN. Love, back in the first period, Craig, Ondrej Pavlik. This was a scary moment.
Top left corner during a stoppage of play on an icing call, and down he goes. Give credit to the training staffs of both hockey teams. They were out in a matter of seconds to help support Pavlik. Off to the hospital he went. So far, he's conscious, which is a good thing, but we'll have more information, we think, at the end of this hockey game.